Yesterday, the Moderna coronavirus trials showed promising early results, and that sent the stock market soaring. Moderna closed up 20%, and that's based on early pre-trial results from just 8 patients. Imagine what will happen when they actually find a vaccine that works. And there are currently 28 companies working on a COVID-19 cure, and of those 28, 21 are traded publicly on the markets. The biggest returns for a vaccine stock would be if you picked one of these companies early and got in on the pre-gains before they went big. The danger with the smaller companies is their stocks are likely to rise during the race for the vaccine. However, if they're not the winner, their prices could come crashing down. That said, I think there is a way to play the coronavirus stocks where you've got a good potential upside with limited risk. I believe the best approach for the vaccine stocks is to play the pharmaceutical stocks with the largest market cap that are going to be a good pick whether or not they win the vaccine race or not. Today's video should be a lot of fun, and be sure to stick around to the very end because at some point in this video, I'm going to sneak in a bonus play, and if you're not paying attention, you're going to miss it. Of course, I'm not a financial advisor, and this video is for entertainment purposes only, so grab a cup of coffee and hang on because this is not your normal stock channel. This video is going to be fast-paced, and we're going to cover a lot of fundamental data. If you've not already seen my video on how to analyze stocks, I really encourage you to check it out because it covers everything in detail. All right, let's start with a news article from CNBC. Stock market live Monday, Dow up 900, Moderna positive vaccine data, Powell says no limit. Market makes comeback from May losses after promising info on Moderna vaccine. U.S. equities banked sharp gains on Monday as news from a biotech company Moderna trial stoked optimism about a potential COVID-19 vaccine. Stocks also got a boost from hopes the economy reopening will spur economic recovery. I put a lot of time, work, and effort into my videos, and if you appreciate them and would like to see more, be sure to support the channel with a like and subscribe. As long as this channel's growing, I'll keep producing these videos. Welcome to Beast Mode Stock Analysis. Today we're going to be going over the stocks Moderna, ticker mRNA, Pfizer, ticker PFE, GlaxoSmithKline, ticker GSK, Johnson & Johnson, ticker JNJ, Eli Lilly & Company, ticker LLY, Sanofi, ticker SNY, Emergent BioSolutions, ticker EBS, Inovio Pharmaceuticals, ticker INO, Novavax, ticker NVAX, and BioNTech, ticker BNTX. There's always a lot more information in Beast Mode Stock Analysis than I go over in each video, and if you haven't already seen my video, How to Analyze Stocks, I really encourage you to check it out. There's a few things you should know about Beast Mode. Anything highlighted in blue is something that's really important to me. The second level of importance is generally the green, and the third level is the tan. And I also have cheat sheet notes here, where an up arrow means I'm looking for a high value, and a down arrow means that I'm looking for a lower value. I've also made a few recent additions to Beast Mode, and today we're going to go over any of those. So if it's highlighted here in red, that's a new addition. And one of my favorite additions is the stock price return over 2 years. And this is the total change in stock price over the last 2 years, and it's adjusted for dividends and splits. So we can see Moderna has had a 0% gain over 2 years, Pfizer at 14.87%. GlaxoSmithKline at 13.53%, Johnson & Johnson at very nice 27.94%, Lilly 100%, Sanofi 32%, EBS 72%, INO 184%, NVAX 65%. Beast Mode Stock Analysis is broken down into different sections, and our first section is the earnings, income, and growth, and this tells us whether or not a company is making money. So the first thing we want to check is whether or not it's got an earnings per share and their PE ratio. So here we can see that the PE ratio for Moderna, which was all over the news yesterday because they've got some good pre-trial results for the coronavirus, they're at negative 58.73, Pfizer at 13.4, GlaxoSmithKline at 15.61, J&J at 23, Lilly at 25, SNY at 31.77, and EBS at 69, and then the rest are negative. So if they don't have earnings, that means that they're going to be a technical play for me, and they're not very strong on the fundamentals. So we'll go ahead and mark those with a checkbox that turns them to red, and now I know that they're better for technical analysis. The nice thing about Beast Mode Stock Analysis is the sheet kind of has a way of working itself out, and you'll see that the cream rises to the top. Now, blue is very important to me, and we've got the net income margin, and here what's standing out to me is Pfizer has a net income margin of 31.17%. We can see where everybody else comes in. Most of them are in the same range. A few are a little on the lower side. And then what really stands out are the companies that are growth companies. They've got big negatives.
The return on equity measures how effectively management is using a company's assets to create profits. So if they've got an ROE near 14%, which is the S&P 500 average, that's a real good ratio, that or higher. If it's less than 10%, it's poor. So what stands out for me here is Pfizer, GSK, and Lilly all have a good return on equity. The return on invested capital is a new metric I've got here, and it measures a company's ability to create value for all of its stakeholders, and it's similar to the shareholder yield. So what we can see here are several companies are doing well. Again, these are all of the established companies with a lower PE ratio. The financial section of Beast Mode tells us whether or not the companies are running on good margins. Several of these are very important, and you might want to study these in a little bit more detail. But the one I'm looking at the most today is the operating margin, and we want that to be above 10%. And the S&P 500 average is 10.8%. The nice thing when we're looking at sectors is all of them should be relatively close together. And we can see that for the strong companies like Pfizer, GlaxoSmithKline, Johnson & Johnson, and Lilly, they're all coming in the upper 20s. So that's what stands out the most here is these guys are looking pretty solid. The balance sheet section of the Beast Mode stock analysis tells us whether or not a company is financially stable, and I've added the cash ratio, which is a short-term ratio used to assess a company's short-term liquidity. The cash ratio formula is the most conservative form of a company's liquidity ratio and is calculated by dividing the cash and cash equivalents of the company by the current liability and signifies the company's total ability to pay short-term liabilities with its highest liquid assets. What we notice here is we've got a very high number for Moderna, for EVS, INO, NVAX, and BNTX. And the reason why is these guys are pharmaceutical companies that are looking for vaccines. They're not very well established. They don't have a high PE ratio. So there's been a lot of money pumped into them because they have high hopes that they'll be able to develop a vaccine. So a lot of money has been pumped into these guys because there's high hopes that they will be able to develop a vaccine. And while there's high hopes, this is also a higher risk-reward play. Meanwhile, we've got our giants with higher caps like Pfizer, GSK, J&J. These guys have a much lower ratio, but they also have a much lower PE ratio, and they're seen as a very solid company. The TATL ratio is the total assets versus total liabilities, and I like to see a ratio of 2 or higher as a general rule of thumb, and it will vary depending on the sector that we're in. Here we can see that Moderna actually has a very high TATL ratio of 4.8. We can see all of the giants are coming in between a little over 1 to about 1.6, and the developmental companies, they've got some money pumped into them, so they're actually coming in a little higher than one would expect as well, but that's common for the pharmaceutical industry. I've got a new ratio that I just added, and it's the net debt divided by the EBITDA ratio, and this is calculated by dividing the net debt by the EBITDA. And this ratio shows how many years it would take to pay back debt if the net debt and EBITDA remain constant. So here, the lower the number, the better. As we move into phase two of Beast Mode stock analysis, this is where we get into the valuations, price targets, and analyst sentiment, and everything here is subjective. I like to look at the fair value intrinsic estimator and the beta ratio, and these will give us conservative estimates. So the estimated intrinsic value for mRNA is $52.51, and it's currently trading at $80. Again, they've been at the top of the news, record highs, and that's to be expected. This is not a fundamental play, but it can be played from a technical analysis, high risk, high reward. Then we look at companies like Pfizer, and they've got a current stock price of $38.07, and they've got an estimated intrinsic value of $43.29. That's a little more interesting to me, and I'll let you guys go across here and draw your own conclusions. The analyst recommendations can give us a good idea on whether or not we're looking at these stocks the same way as the analyst. Now, of course, the analysts aren't always right, but it's a quick check reference. And here we can see that most of these are coming in with buy and hold ratios. And the highest number of buy recommendations is actually coming in for Johnson & Johnson. The analyst price targets are fun to look at, and I like to look at the analyst target mean price because I want to stay conservative. And anytime we've got a current stock price that is trading over the estimated intrinsic value and over the analyst target mean price, that's a real good indication that it might be overvalued. So here we've got mRNA trading at $80. It has an estimated intrinsic value of $52.21, and the analyst target mean price is $76.83. So it's trading over that, definitely a sign of being overvalued. Now, of course, they just had really big news on the vaccine. If they can deliver, they'll end up being worth a lot more than where they are now. But again, this is a very high risk play because it's still very early in the ballgame. And then you'll notice a company like Pfizer, they're currently trading at $38.07. Their intrinsic value is $43.29, and their analyst target mean price is $42.75. So it's showing that it's got a little room to run upwards, but it's not nearly as overvalued as the rest of them. Then if we come over here and we look at INO, NVAX, and BNTX, we'll notice that all of them have a current price that is trading over the estimated intrinsic value and the analyst target mean price. So let's just take BNTX as an example. They're currently trading at $60.17. The intrinsic value is $50.79. And this number is not an exact science, so always look at that as just one data point. And then we've got an analyst target mean price of $42.53. Definitely signs are pointing that this one is overvalued. So from a fundamental standpoint, absolutely not a good deal. However, from technical analysis, where you're using the charts and looking at patterns, you can definitely play these and make money. Just two different approaches to the market. The Piotrowski score is always a fun one to look at, and this helps us find companies with a healthy liquid balance sheet, profitability, and operating efficiency. So here we're looking for a number that's 5 or higher, and for Moderna, we can see they come in at a very low 2. Meanwhile, the big pharmaceutical companies, Pfizer, GSK, Johnson & Johnson, and LLY, they're all coming in with a much higher and more respectable number. And our last stop today is the Relative Strength Index, which is a momentum indicator, and it can give indications of whether a stock is overbought and oversold. And on the RSI, it's typically believed that if it's at 70 or above, it's a sign that the stock is overbought, and it might be a good idea to start selling or looking for a time to take profits. So we can see right now that Moderna is coming in at 81.56, which is a very high RSI number. We can also see that EBS and NVAX are coming in high as well.
As you can see, there's a ton of data in the Beast Mode Stock Analysis. And if you want me to keep producing these videos, be sure to like and subscribe to the channel to keep it growing. I'm also frequently asked if I share my spreadsheet, and I don't because it has so much custom coding in it. Thanks for understanding. Overall, I see these big cap pharmaceutical stocks as a smart play long term. Right now, the vaccine race is early. So if we're able to get in now and one of them pops, that's even gonna be a bigger bonus for us. So my number one pick is GlaxoSmithKline. I think they've got a lot of upside potential. My number two pick is Pfizer, and they could have just as easily been my number one pick because their fundamentals are very, very strong. And number three is Johnson & Johnson. Their numbers are rock solid, and again, I mean, all three of these picks are really strong today. And the best part is, even if these companies' vaccines fail, they're still solid growth companies that offer a lot of long-term investment potential. I'm not a financial advisor, and I always encourage you to do all of your own research and to draw your own conclusions. I've got some really good news if you're interested in Webull. They just brought back their program where you can get 2 free stocks valued up to $1,400. So if you don't already have a Webull account, check the promo link in the description below.
If you have not already, make sure you sign up for Webull to get a free stock worth up to $1,400. Webull is much more than a free stock trading app. And I have a free tutorial video on Webull that's so good, Webull actually called me after viewing it. Both the promo and Webull tutorial link are in the description below.
Thanks for sticking with me to the very end. Here's your bonus play. When you want to develop a new drug or medical device, MedPace Holdings, which is ticker MEDP, provides full-service clinical trial outsourcing from early phase 1 clinical trials through phase 3 pre-FDA approval clinical trials. MEDP has a PE ratio of 28 and a net income margin of 12.37. The nice thing about this play is they benefit from the vaccine race by providing supporting services without the volatility risk. You definitely want to check them out. Well, thanks for hanging out with me today. Be sure to sound off in the comments below and let me know your thoughts on this video and some suggestions for future videos. I'll see you tomorrow with a fresh new video.